War Thunder can be quite frustrating as a noob, but do not fear, here's all you need to become a decent tanker. Okay, first things first. The single most important thing is to put some reputable artwork on your tanks and planes so your teammates instantly know they can trust you. With that said, let's go over the less important things. One of them is ranging. Aiming your gun at something and press R to get its estimated distance. Every horizontal line on your reticle stands for 200 meters. Now aim and shoot. Congratulations, hitting things just became a lot easier. But here's another trick. If you're defending an area, measure your distance to a prominent object roughly in the middle of your protected area. This is your reference point. It lets you easily judge how far tanks in front of it or behind it are away from your position. No need to re-estimate the distance of each target popping up now. Next up are binoculars. Press B to use them. Now your view is a bit elevated, which lets you glimpse over obstacles without showing yourself. It's also great for scouting other players while driving a light tank. Left-click anywhere to automatically aim your gun at the desired spot. Press B again to exit binoculars and then instantly open fire. This could save you precious seconds, which often decides whether you live on or get wrecked. Still, shooting first is worth nothing without knowing where to aim. So, get to know the weak spots of the most common tanks you're facing in your current battle rating bracket. That's easily done by playing around with the protection analysis within the customization menu of each specific tank. Just play the game, note the names of tanks you struggle to take down, and check them out in the protection analysis after the match has finished. Learn as you go. Then there's hiding. Hiding is one of the most important things to do in a tank battle, even as a heavy tank. If no one knows you're there, you can't get shot. Remember that you can even shut down your tank's engine with the I key to go completely silent. Use cover and concealment to your advantage. Cover is massive, a house for example. You can't get shot behind it. Concealment is just hiding you visually, like bushes and trees. They both have their advantages, depending on the type of tank you're driving. If you have a turret and you're able to move out of cover quickly, get a shot off and then retreat, solid cover is your best choice most of the time. Cover also gives the opportunity to get into a hull down position, which means you're only showing your turret while the rest of your tank stays protected. If you're in a tank destroyer without a turret, but with a low profile and highly sloped armor so it can take a shot or two, concealment might work better for you. Good example would be the German Jagdpanzer IV. Another very important thing is awareness. It probably is the strongest weapon of your whole arsenal. First rule is, always have an eye on the minimap. This lets you keep track of your teammates. If they start to disappear in a certain area, you probably should be very careful if you choose to investigate. Flank around and see if you can spot some possible targets. Look out for entrenched or hidden tanks you maybe didn't notice earlier. Also, if you hear
"Attention to the designated grid zone!"
then pay
"Attention to the designated grid zone!"
Someone probably has spotted a threat there. Left click on the map to make these calls by yourself. Supporting each other and keeping your teammates alive is the key to win a match. Also, don't move too much. What some call camping is a core principle of tank combat. Only move when it makes sense, like to push into a new offensive position or to get into cover. This brings me to engine smoke. Even if you think you're hidden, you might still be visible. Always be on the lookout for suspiciously moving smoke within bushes or behind the edge of a hill. Also, hold C to freely move the camera and abuse the third-person view to peek around corners. If everything still went to hell and you're in a direct tank versus tank fight out in the open, then angle your tank. There are some special cases, but angling mostly helps. Every tank is different, so learn the advantages and drawbacks of your vehicle's specific armor design. Sloped armor largely increases the chances of a shell bouncing instead of penetrating your tank and blowing Fritz, Franz, Kurt and Heinz into a million Einzelteile. Another measure to prevent this horrible scenario is to reduce the amount of ammunition you carry. Every single round inside your tank may lead to an ammo rack explosion if it gets hit. So get statistics on your side and only take the amount of shells you really need with you. Now, on some occasions you face something you can't reliably kill. If that's the case, then cripple it. Shoot the gun barrel first, then track your opponent. Now you can either flank, retreat, or carefully aim for a small weak spot. Let's also take a brief look at light tanks. If you're driving one of these speedy guys, then quickly rushing into a superior position and then shooting other light tanks trying the same thing is something you should do. But you need some map knowledge first, so just play the game. And don't get too far into enemy territory if you don't know 100% what you're doing. Just find a good spot and wait for targets. It's also good to abuse stabilizers. If your tank has one, it enables you to fire on the move. Regulate your speed with the Q and E keys. The slower you go, the better your stabilizer works. It will greatly enhance your aim in rough terrain and while crossing ledges and similar obstacles. Driving down a street slowly sometimes even draws enemies out of hiding because they think you can't aim reliably while moving. And last but not least, mark enemies with your machine gun. They will light up on the map for the rest of your team the moment you hit them. This will give away your position too, so use this option thoughtfully. Oh, and I almost forgot, have some close air support at the ready if a point you defend gets overrun. Fight until you get blown up, then jump into your plane, and you know what to do. Everyone will rush the point to cap it, so fly there and deliver your payload. Easy money, boom! Or sometimes, if you're the last one defending a point, it's better to stay a little bit in front of it and wait for it to get captured. Greedy people will then mindlessly rush past your position to spawn camp. Now make them suffer. Sometimes you will remove a lot of people from the match this way and your team takes the comeback victory. Now, take this wisdom, fire up your Panzer and move out. Thanks for watching, thumbs down if you hate my tips and you'd rather go down with a Bismarck than have to watch this video again. If you enjoyed the video, then consider to like, comment and subscribe. Have fun, fly safe and see you next time.